Retrononymous Gaming. Welcome to the stream, folks. Today we are going to play through INMOST. Hang out, stay a while and watch this sad story unfold.
I'm hiding here. I'm very good at hiding. No one has been able to find me for years, or maybe everyone has just gone home. Now I'm sad. I helped my brother hide behind the houses. Don't look for him, please. It was hard, but someone had to do it. Drop my key down the well. That is going to punish me. Why did you do it? Why did you push me? Why is this happening to me? Sobbing.
ESAW8982WA78. Wanna become famous? Buy followers, primes and views on bigfollows.com, bigfollows.com. The Joshua 3345. Wanna become famous? Buy followers, primes and views on bigfollows.com, bigfollows.com.
Do you remember it? That tale about flowers? I thought it was a good story. I thought it's sure to have a happy ending. It's a tale about pain, let me tell you, again. These lands were dead, destroyed, and devastated. All you could hear was the whisper of the ashes. Then, a stranger came. He held a spark in his hand. The stranger opened his hand, and the spark was set free. Light returned. Yet pain was the price for this light. screaming filled the air. Time passed. The screaming grew silent. Pain became a familiar friend. Some disappeared from the lands. No one knew whether they had crept away or been taken by pain. Yet many also remained. Castles which once rose into the skies fell into ruins. Time wiped clean any trace. Centuries passed. The people started calling the stranger the Keeper of the Spark. He kept watch over the land, soaking up the pain of its people. But the people had hope. They were growing flowers.
Thank you.
was the light of the spark. Terrible its price. Out of fear. Others served the keeper out of greed, expecting to be rewarded for their service. Went into the lands and they gathered the pain. And thus the pain multiplied. And their own hearts blackened. No one knew where the people kept disappearing to. In the meantime, the pure-hearted grew their flowers, for the secret of the flowers lives on. Thank you. those in the service of the Keeper could not grow vulnerable. The knight could never grow his own flower. He stole someone else's. But the stolen flower would never accept him. It's wrong. The knight will be forever damned for this. For all eternity.
Sean Alloway. Respect the cock.
Sean, what up, brother? Hopefully you're respecting the cock, bro. I know I am. Sean with the like. Thank you, brother.
Sean Alloway. Morning.
Top of the morning to you, brother.
Sean Alloway. Running with a 1 HR of sleep, lol.
Why are you running on 1 hour of sleep, bro? Yeah, you walk on 1 hour of sleep instead of run.
Sean Alloway. Mike Rain.
That sucks, brother. Hope it goes away for you. Some people go to sleep to get rid of headaches, and I personally can't go to sleep when I have a headache. Retrononymous Gaming at gmail.com.
Sean Alloway. But I got to do some stuff before having to pick up my little one from school in 30 minutes, so have a good one.
Alright, brother. Take care of yourself. Hope your headache goes away and get some rest.
Thank you.
For as long as the spark shines over these lands, pain is locked inside every soul. Many have given up, accepting that the pain inside them will never subside. Where the Keeper has no dominion over them. Those whose souls turned black, who gave in to their desires. Even they believe. But the Keeper won't ever let them go. Harvest and nurture and steal. and even more so, the pain they suffer themselves.
Thank you.
No one can leave while the Keeper still needs them. From the Keeper's ever-vigilant gaze. The flower fills their hearts with love, and the love stands in the way of the pain. As the Keeper no longer has use for it. But those who serve the Keeper can never have their own soul flower. There is no escape for them, for black are their souls. Even if you steal a flower, it'll never be yours. Such things should never happen. powers must stay with those who gave them life.
Thank you. He never was a knight, you know. One way or another, we all serve the Keeper. And we all have our desires. Most importantly, his heart was not all black. He had grown his own soulflower. He did not manage to save it, though. And that was his undoing. And she, well, she never forgave him. But yes, he did steal that second flower. Is something you do not know, though. You were too young then, and no one told you. Everyone was so busy, so preoccupied with their own pain. He stole the flower from death. Stole you away. Accepted you with all his heart. She couldn't, though. She blamed him. She blamed you. Some have to face more pain than they can handle. And the pain broke her. She wanted them to leave together. To follow their flower. And that night, they did leave. She took him with her. She took my son. the pain stays with us forever. It can subside. It may grow dull, but it'll never leave us. And we live with it, doing our best not to let it dissolve us. We fight it every day. But there are different kinds of pain. There's sacrificing yourself. The father, consumed by work, trying to give his child a better future. The mother, dedicating herself to her family until there is nothing left of her. Your pain is the price you pay to make someone else feel better. To make someone else smile, if only for a moment. But trading someone else's happiness for your pain is not the only way. Life doesn't want your pain. It doesn't need your suffering. It simply is what it is. You don't have to fight it. All we can do is remember those who are gone and do our best for those who remain. All of us carry our pain within us. Another way, even if you're in pain, another way is to take someone else's pain and make it your own.
Do you remember it? That tale about pain? I was wrong. It's a tale about love. I will tell you. Tell you once again.
Thank you.